Hello, everybody. Welcome to game number 11 of VGP as Batman. Lizardman can be a bit tricky. Oh, damn it, he's got 10k in the bank. Oh, shit. Imagine if it had only been 130k difference. Oh, fuck. Oh, I'm sad about that. Didn't get to see the team or the record or anything, but never mind. Should have looked at that. But, wow. Wow, that's pretty sad. Yeah, I should have looked at things. But I've got my trusty Mordrek.com here, so I can see his record in the records. Okay. So he's receiving. He's got 12 players. All he's got is a sidestep guard. Oh no, he's got 4 block and a mighty blow. Oh god, he's got really. He's got pretty good Saurus. Because this is a lot of blow at this movement guy. Obviously, he's got the potential to win games. But he's a hell of a lot of blow, isn't he? I guess I've got a mighty blow tackler to hunt down the skinks. Dodge. No strength, no guard. Could be very, and he's got the wizard as well. Could be very tricky. Very tricky indeed. What's his coach? The coach is James. So what I can do is go on the old. He is 3-1-4 with this team. That's bizarre, isn't it? That is bizarre. And he's 0-0-1 with another Wizard Man team. So. Oh, bro. Yeah, this. He's expensive, isn't he, this Blitzer? 160k. That's a lot. That is a lot of TV. But, I mean, he'll get a lot better once he gets Dodge, won't he? He's a lot more worth his TV when he has Dodge. And if he had Agility, it would be ridiculous. But he would eventually... I mean, he'll... I would take the Edge just because... Fucking hell, I mean. Yeah, one of his wins is by concession as well, yeah, that's true. To be fair, Lizardmen get the most concessions out of them, more concessions than anybody. So yeah, he's 2-1-5 if you regard the concession, if you disregard the concession. But that's not really fair too, because Lizardmen do get the most concession victories, because obviously they're the most kind of oppressive team, really, aren't they? Guinness, the world champion, has an 11-2-0 Lizardman team, and 7 of his wins were by concession. I don't know how many of those because he was trash talking his opponent and pissed them off, but that's a lot of concession wins, isn't it? But that's what Lizardmen like, aren't they? I mean, what do you even do against them half the time? They're disgusting. I think it definitely is important enough to take, yeah, price, just because it's just two. The movement on Dark, movement is the only thing that Dark Elves lack, isn't it? So yeah, like, obviously it delays you. If you take it first, if you take it before Blodge, it does suck a bit. But the payoff is just huge, isn't it? Now, if you've got Bloodstep, then definitely. It's not even. Not even thinking about if you've got Bloodstep. After Bloodstep, all I want is stats. Just show you can get a tackle on some people, but. I can't really surf him because I'd have to have two people here. One dice him, or minus two dice. Yeah, I would still take it first skill on a witch. Just because you've still got dodge and you can still just carry the ball with him and stuff. Oh wow, he's just going to just see now, if I'd known his record, I would have maybe anticipated the attrition fireball. Oh god. I could have set up differently. Nothing from Pom Blitz. Pom? Blow Blitz. Not even worth dodging him out, is it? Well, we'll put him there so we can't be pushed into another main Blow Blitz. The KO is the Superman. is the Super Batman. Yep, killed him at the end there. Kaz, at least it was a journeyman who died. He's taken loads of deaths recently, it's really annoying. Yeah, tackling down attack is fine. But yeah, that's the thing with. Just with Dark Elves in general, like after Blood Step, I just want doubles and stacks. Because you can have you can take tackle and stuff. Like obviously you're gonna take tackle on elves. More tackle than bash teams can have. Just because you don't need to take as you don't get to take guard and mighty blow as much, but yeah. Oh yeah, you only want leap on your agility 5, don't you? Yeah, he went for the attrition fireball turn 1. Which I let myself into it a little bit. Can't really surf because of this fucking guy. I mean, he keeps activating his croc, so I guess eventually he'll bonehead with him. And then I'll have a chance. Could 2D him and then 2D him. I could blitz him up, and I think that's what I want to do. Even though I could block with a witch elf. Use Mighty Blow. I never check really normally whether it uses Mighty Blow. I'm just happy that I've blitzed with the correct player, as it were. really want to block him, but then it means giving up a block, doesn't it? Which isn't so ideal. Can surf here, can't he, if I am skullless? So I guess I was committed to a reroll. I don't want to give up blocks, especially when I've taken the Kaz already. Thank you, Brain on Slugs. Not really, to be to be honest. Went on holiday and it got worse. But I'm going to smash the games anyway, just because I've got two, haven't I? I've actually got to smash the games to track qualify, so. Could minus 2D the crocs there, couldn't I? Wouldn't be the worst thing in the world. He's got no ideas other than base everything every time. Which is fair enough as Lizardmen, isn't it? Right, so knocking this guy down seems a good idea, doesn't it? Because that opens the path then to sack the ball. No, I accept. Now the push puts the guard in, doesn't it? Which isn't so good. So I guess I'm not trying to sack the ball. So therefore, it's coming around here to make things safe. Can we roll this dodge? Good. See, I didn't think about this. I didn't think of this first. I didn't think of double sculling. I guess if I eat it, then no, I don't want to. I want to maybe kill a skink. It stops me taking a mighty blow block, doesn't it? If I'd just taken the skulls. Hello, Sean. Yeah, I'm not sure about that, Jellio. I'm not sure about that. But that's the thing, isn't it? That's the thing about this shitty fucking 15-second. That's the thing about this 15-second thing. Unless you anticipate rolling a double skull with your fucking, you know, if you, it's so moronic. Oh my god, it's ludicrous, isn't it? It's completely fucking ludicrous. That you have to think. Oh look, there's a 1 in 36 chance that I'll double skull this. Better think for more than 15 seconds. Every 36 times when it doesn't fucking matter. Wow. And obviously Mighty Blow got him the KO, but it used up the action of the Crocs. God, I hate the 15-second thing. I really fucking hate it. It's so dumb. I can't believe anybody fucking defends it. Jesus fucking Christ. Oh man. Oh no, he didn't even blitz the guy to squeeze him against the sideline. Guard's actually protecting him, isn't he, from a multitude of things. I mean, I could just minus 2D him with armor 7. That doesn't seem very clever, though, does it? Especially as the push isn't good enough. He could 1D him. I'm going to hit him now. There's no real way to do it apart from the one dicer. Sidestepper could run around there. Could just try to surf him. It's all pretty crap, isn't it? Just started off with a smooth 1D pound. This is a bit problematic. There's none of the players to get in the way so much too. I don't want to reroll anything. It's not that bad though, because it means a 2D here, doesn't it? Sorry, can't log on. Yeah, I should put that on, shouldn't I? That's not the one. There you go. There's the... Yeah, that's what I should have when it comes on. There you go. Hello, Mitchell, thank you. Rewritten 150k. Not in the room. That's the thing, isn't it? Yeah, for 300k you can get on the chef and get nothing. That's ridiculous, isn't it? So it's hard to fucking toss them, isn't it? Come on, I just need to roll his crux to go to Bonehead. He's activated him every turn. I just want him to Bonehead once, then he just gives up the sack. Manny Lone is it? Shit. Holy fucking shit. Oh man. Could 1D him, but it's with Loner, isn't it? But the payoff is so sweet. Even pushing him. Oh, but then the block, you'd have to block there to do it. So maybe just stand him up, blitz this one. To maybe get the 1D surf. Let me put another guy in. Could minus two demon just go for the push, even without block? But then it just seems like not a good thing to do against this chap, does it? He could dodge and I could surf the skink. But then I'd have to dodge first, which is obviously just crap. He's going to come in. I got that. Yeah, that's okay, that is. Hello. I don't know what he's going to do there, but fuck it. Yeah, it was an attrition fireball. Running out of time here. Only just got the movement to score now. It's just never going to fail his bonehead ever. Gotta fucking go for the dive bomb this turn. Minus 2D or something. Something stupid. Maybe he's trying to surf his own Saurus, that'd be pretty good, wouldn't it? I'd be happy with that. Surf his own Saurus, yeah. You could do it to surf the Witch Elf. Fucking so annoying, this guard Crocs is just unbeatable. For fuck's sake. Oh man. It's just crazy. I guess it didn't epiphany, no, it didn't. That was pretty shit, wasn't it? But I mean, it used his blitz, so it wasn't so bad. I just can't do anything. I've just got a minus 2D in. That's literally it. That's the extent of my options, and even then, it's just a 1D on the ball. Fucking horrible. score, except maybe with this pitch. He's going to take the ball down, isn't he? Oh, I'm fucking pissed off. Right, I'm just going to mute myself for a while. Sorry, everybody. One hit on the tackle all game, of course, he gets his armor broken. Or if he just failed fucking Bonehead once. Maybe I should have gone for the minus 2D one time when he faced the block down. Maybe I should have done. And yeah, of course he's going for foul. It's not even that bad now that he's got the reserve. He's late in that. If he scores a shield, yeah, just knock out the whole fucking team. Oh man. Well, isn't it someone who's got a losing record with Lizard Man? Hard to take, isn't it? Great, isn't it? Sidestep, eh? Don't tab out if you've got a sidestep, though. It's gonna be a really fucking good ball, too. What a shit game. What a fucking shit game, man. Half my team's fucking knocked out. He's just done nothing. I should have maybe minus 2D'd that. not one the one chance I got the minus 2D in like in a good way. Well, I should have done it. I guess, and now I've got to try and win, haven't I? So I guess maybe Zach can score a one turn here if the knocked out guy comes back. So we've got to get only 50-50 to even have a chance of a one turn. It might be him. Yeah, alright, so got half a chance. This is fucking shit, bro. Jesus Christ. It's so fucking annoying, it's doing nothing. Like, the good thing is he's set up terribly. The bad thing is I've got no fucking players to score. Can't fucking do it. I need two assists in, which takes all of these guys to then push him forward there. I just literally can't fucking do it. Gotta do a one dice or some shit. I can't fucking even hear myself. This is why I hate the gap strategy, because I needed one push to set it up, then two more, and I just think it's terrible having the gap strategy. Never ever do it normally, but obviously I didn't have the fucking players. Had to do it. Absolute load of shit. I'm tilted off the face of the earth now. I'm not really tilted, I'm not playing bad, I'm just fucking pissed off the face of the earth. Can't even play fucking songs because of fucking YouTube. Pissed off. Oh, like off the charts pissed off. I was looking forward to this before I started. That's Blood Bowl, isn't it, eh? Of course, every single time you try to go down one side, they get a perfect defense or a blitz. Absolutely fucking typical. He's just doing that. A draw isn't the end of the world, you're joking, right? Somebody who's lost more than they've won with lizard men. And drawing against somebody who's lost more than they've won with lizard men. With fucking lizard men, they've lost more than they've won. I can't even comprehend that. I'm not even playing bad, that's the worst thing. And maybe could have kept that double skull, maybe. And maybe should have gone for the minus 2D on the Roxas at one point. But I mean, that wasn't really... You know, I wasn't completely wrong. I'm just an absolute fucking... I'm so pissed off, and I've got to fucking play 5 more fucking games after this. What a lot of shit. So on that basis, I'm just going to stop like streaming, if you like. I'm gonna turn off the second monitor, turn off the fucking, you know, minimize that and not look at chat, not respond to chat, not say anything. I'm just gonna fucking play for the rest of the fucking thing. Of course, I'm 10-0, with a fan factor of therefore about 10. He's won 3, lost 4. Yet he's the one that benefits from the pitch invasion. Brilliant. Brilliant. I needed 5 pluses and he needs 6, and he gets 3 and I get 2. At least this guy still has been pretty lucky for me. But holy shit, he hasn't failed a block. He hasn't failed a bonehead or a block. It's just stupid, isn't it? It's absolutely fucking stupid. Well, this would be alright if the movement 9 guy was fucking wasn't blocked by everybody. She can pick it up. Pass it to him or something. Not really. Hand it off to someone. Thank you.
That is simply not true. The data does not support your assertion.
Shame I wasted my fucking apple, didn't I? Thank you.
That's it, man. Game over, man. It's game over.
Well, thank fuck for that. Holy shit. Sort that off the face of the planet now. Never mind. Yeah, I fouled it. I can't believe you've never seen that foul. Go. I foul a lot with the Witch Elves because it is a great animation, and I foul to get sent off, quite often with the Witch Elves. I managed to screen the good players with the Apo being gone. On a completely irrelevant Apo. Bet he wished he'd Apo that KO. Unbelievable that KO stayed out all night. I didn't even really get unlucky this game, I just... just got horribly pissed off. I'll try to get some swords, but... Oh wow, he fouled the fucking... the guy instead of the journey. What an asshole. I don't think I've ever seen a minor fight, to be honest. Yeah, the Witch Elf foul is amazing. Completely amazing. Alright. 150k is perfect. Turn him down. Turn him down. Turn him down. 23 is okay, I guess. But, oh no, it's not, because he'd have been on 18 anyway, wouldn't he? Bit shit. Alright, 15, 10. Let's have a look at this. A double. Alright, that's definitely guard. Don't need to think about that for a second. Gotta sack these guys. No point keeping them. Alright, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 players. Maybe it's worth having 2 journeymen, but I think I'll probably want to get the blitzer as soon as possible. Get him skilled up to dodge. Probably want max blitzers, even though I've got a rule of 5 at the moment with these 3 blitzers and these 2 witch elves. So could almost wait for these him to get a touchdown, him to get a touchdown before I had the 4th blitzer. I'll think about it. Also have the 150k, so that's another reason to play another game and then buy the blitzer. But there you go, 11-0. Not bad. Not bad in the end. I was so fucking pissed off during that game. And I wasn't even unlucky. Like, that's the craziest thing. I guess I played too passively. I should have gone for it on the -2D. But with him having a bad record with Lizardmen, it made me not want to push my luck. You know, I thought I should just be able to win without taking any risks. He didn't fail any blocks in the first half. He didn't fail his bonehead at all in the first half, despite activating him every single turn. So it was completely unjustified rage, but I was really fucking raging first half, crazy. But he was the first person to actually score a touchdown that I didn't want scored against me, which is crazy. So fair play to him, you know. It is what it is. I shouldn't have got so angry, but I did. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe, and stay fantastic.